Alaska is one of the most scenic, beautiful, natural places in the entire world. We have over 170 million acres of forested land. 17 of the 20 highest peaks in the United States are located in Alaska. Visitors come from around the world to marvel at our wildlife, to hike, camp, and fish in our forests, and simply enjoy spectacular views that can be found nowhere else. But living here amongst all these trees and grasslands can sometimes come with a price: wildfires. In the year 2015, there were 766 wildfires in Alaska, the second worst fire season ever recorded. 350 of those were human-caused. The other 416 were started by lightning. In 1 week, over 50,000 lightning strikes started 295 fires. 5.1 million acres of forest burned in Alaska in 2015. That's an area the size of the entire states of Connecticut and Delaware combined. We're lucky here in Alaska because we have the brave men and women of the Alaska Division of Forestry, who are the experts at fighting wildfires. Every year, they're out saving hundreds of homes and buildings in the path of wildfires, both on the ground and in the air. But even these heroes need help. Every year, they call on their secret weapon to help them save homes around the state. What is that secret weapon? It's you. You see, in times of emergency, firefighters sometimes face fires that threaten multiple homes at the same time, but they don't always have the resources available to them to save them all. They have to make fast, tough decisions on what to do, sometimes only having minutes or seconds to decide. And that's where you come in. There is so much you can do at your home to make it safe during a wildfire and give the firefighters more time and resources to do their jobs. It's time to make you Alaska Firewise. The first step is to understand how wildfires can endanger homes. Burning embers from wildfires can travel 2 to 3 miles in the wind and land on top of houses, or in dirty gutters, or accumulate in areas where leaves or needles pile up. Fires will creep along lawns and over brush or foliage that is nearby. Fires will move from treetop to treetop, moving extremely quickly, especially in high winds. There are many factors that affect how fires spread. The more fuel available, like trees, brush, or piles of leaves, the faster a fire will burn. If there hasn't been a lot of rain and the vegetation is dry, the higher the fire danger. Wind speed is very important in the spread of fire. All fires are dangerous, but if there are high winds, fire will spread extremely fast. Embers may start fires miles away, and the fire will burn hotter and faster. Fire can be fast and dangerous, but really, it's a simple equation. Fire needs fuel to burn. Take away or limit the fuel, and there's nothing to burn. Keep that fuel away from your house, and you'll keep fire away too. Your home and everything around it up to 100 feet away is called the home ignition zone. Basically, the goal is to make sure this zone has little or no fuel for a fire to use. From 0 to 5 feet from your house should be free from any sort of fuel source. Things like organic mulch, woody shrubs and plants, juniper bushes, piles of leaves or needles can all catch fire and allow flames to touch the house itself. These things are especially vulnerable when there are burning embers in the air, so even if a fire isn't nearby, it can still be a threat to your house. The zone up to 30 feet from your house needs to be protected from surface fires, and branches or limbs of trees that overhang the roof or come near to the house need to be trimmed back at least 10 feet. Grass and landscaping around the house need to be mowed low and well-watered regularly, if possible. In the zone that goes out 100 feet from your house, there shouldn't be any heavy accumulation of brush or trees, as they will provide far too much fuel for any fire. Any dead vegetation needs to be cleared out regularly. Here are five steps that you can take to assess how firewise your house is. Do these with your parents so the whole family can learn what it takes to be Alaska firewise. Ignition sources. Take a walk around your house and look at all the things that might catch fire. And if you have things like burn barrels, fish smokers, outdoor fire pits or campfires, make sure they're in good working order and safe. General landscaping. Make sure there is nothing directly against your house that can catch fire. 3 feet of gravel around your house is a fantastic way to protect it. And there are many flame-resistant types of plants and vegetation you can plant as well. Building materials. Is your roof fire-resistant? Are the gutters cleaned out of debris and dead leaves on a regular basis? Can fire embers get under or inside your house? Access and signs. Can a fire engine safely make it down your driveway and turn around? Is your address clearly marked? If the firefighters can't find you, they can't help you. Fire pre-plan. All of this can be scary to think about, but if you and your family have a plan, you'll be ready if an emergency happens. One of the best things you can do is build a home Firewise kit and have it nearby. What's in a home Firewise kit? 5 garden hoses with nozzles, 5 sprinklers, a shovel, a rake, and several 5-gallon buckets. If fire threatens, or even if you have to evacuate, hook up the sprinklers and put them around your house and turn them on. The shovel and rake will help clean out anything nearby your house or to put out any smoldering embers. Create a go kit. Okay, we've got your house firewise and ready. Now let's take care of you, your family, and your pets. One of the most important things you can do is to help put together your go kit, a bag you can pack full of supplies and emergency equipment that you can grab in a moment's notice if need be. There are many ways to do this, but here are some suggestions. Use a backpack or a duffel bag for easy storage and carrying. Fill it with things you need: bottled water, granola or protein bars, a change of clothes, a blanket, some zip-top bags to keep things dry, sturdy shoes and a jacket, first aid kit, any prescription medicine you might need, a multifunction tool, cell phone chargers, some cash, basic toiletries. You can make your own bag as well that has some clothes, maybe a teddy bear, your own blanket, and some water. The most important thing is that everyone knows where your go kits are and that you check them from time to time to make sure they're in good shape. Hopefully, you won't ever have to use them, but when fire evacuations happen, they happen fast. But you're Alaska Firewise, so you're ready. So, now you are full of knowledge about wildfires and what to do to protect your house and your family. What's next? It's time to take action. Let's put all this information to work. Talk to your parents and family about how to make your home safer. Help clear away brush from your house and keep the yard neat. Make sure the rain gutters around your house are free from debris and dead leaves. Make a checklist of things to go into your go kit and help put one together. Make a personal emergency plan with your family. Where will you all meet? What will you do if you have to evacuate? What is everyone responsible for? Make sure you know important phone numbers and personal information. If there are wildfires nearby, stay tuned to alerts on your phone, TV, or radio. If there are evacuations happening near you, get ready in case you need to go next. If you do evacuate, be sure to tell other friends and family when you're leaving, where you're going, and when you're safely there. We are lucky to live in the great state of Alaska. with so much natural beauty and millions of acres of forest and wild land. Our state makes up one-fifth of all the land in the United States. But with hundreds and hundreds of fires every year, of all sizes, we simply have to be ready to protect our homes. We've learned so many ways to do that, and with a little preparation, some hard work, and a lot of information, we can all be Alaska Firewise. Visit the Alaska Division of Forestry for more information.